大家好, this is Hello Filipina News. For the headline, Manny Pacquiao for president? Since 2020, Manny Pacquiao has been rumored to run for presidency for Philippine election 2022. Would he win? Would the Filipinos in Taiwan vote for Manny Pacquiao? January 2016, before the election in the Philippines, Mayor Rodrigo Duterte came to Taiwan to meet the Filipino people. He was mobbed and loved by the Filipinos here in Taiwan. Would these people, the same people who voted for Duterte, vote for Manny Pacquiao? Based on our posts online, many Filipinos in Taiwan would love Sara Duterte, the daughter of Rodrigo Duterte, to run for the presidency this 2022. Would she do the challenge? Would she run for president this 2022? And if she runs, would all the Filipino people in Taiwan vote for Sara Duterte? Before the politicians in the Philippines quarrel about who would win the presidential election this 2022, Hello Filipina News received a lot of problems, complaints, and reports on their present situation here in Taiwan. Would the next president of the Philippines solve the problems of the Filipinos here in Taiwan? From the Filipinos here in Taiwan who reported to Hello Filipina, violence, abuse, and maltreatment are not a surprise to any of them. It happens in their dormitories, it happens in their company, and with their brokers. Who can help them? This is the question that we have been telling the people for several times here in Hello Filipina News. They need your help. Who would be the next president that has the capability to solve the problems of the Filipino people living here in Taiwan? Can Sara Duterte do it? Can Manny Pacquiao solve it? Taiwan government is trying to protect the labor rights of the foreign workers here in Taiwan. But is 1-955 hotline enough? Many of the workers reported that every time they call 1-955, they often have these problems. One, a rude call agent. Two, an unsolved case. Three, if they happen to have the result of their case, they will get maltreatment from their broker and their company. According to many of our Filipino friends who reported to us, due to this unfair treatment, many of our friends here would decide to give up and go home. What will happen to their dream for their family if they're forced to get home due to this unfair treatment? This conversation with a labor representative from Taichung would tell everyone that it is quite hopeless for some Filipinos to be mistreated here in Taiwan with their brokers and companies after their complaints.
And 还有这个一个原因，很多菲律宾人会反映给我说，如果他们会反映他们的问题，然后边疆他们的公司还有他们的broker 会导演他们，然后帮他们在那么难过的地方，但难过到他们就放弃，就想回家了，就是不给他们那个加班，还有什么？
不是我可以处理的啊，我可以处理的是说他如果有申诉，比如跟我们说打1955申诉说他有少年问题，那我们 OK 嘛，可以帮他处理。至于说你说他如果申诉完之后，中介公司或是雇主会不会讨厌他，那这个不是我，又不是中介公司，我也不是雇主啊，对不对？ 本来就是申诉的时候，你本来就会遇到这种状况，我们也会跟雇主、跟中介公司说，你不要因为这种事情，然后去排挤那些有问题的外国人，这样。那他们可以打1955吗？如果这个事情又来发生，如果有问题，请他们直接打1955就好了。那如果有遇到外国人，他觉得说他对于他的宿舍还是工作生活有问题，请他直接打1955，1955会去做判断，说到底是要直接处理还是跟他做一些宣导这样。
All they have to do is just to call 1-955 over and over again so that they can file a case against whoever mistreated them. When would this cycle ends? If Manila Economic and Cultural Office cannot help the Filipino people, isn't it about time to have a real agency that is here in Taiwan that can really exercise the rights of a Philippine government representative that could really protect the rights of the Filipino people? This is Chini Huang from Hello Philtai News reporting.